God morgon från Paretodesken. Det är tisdagen den 31 augusti. Sista dagen av sommaren kan man säga. Idag höjer vi kursen på Surgical Science och ska vi prata med en bullish Harry Colvin. Vilken morgon vi har framför oss. Ja, vi börjar i USA och på Wall Street där börserna fortsatte upp igår bortsett från Dow som backade 0,2%. Både S&P och Nasdaq slog däremot nya rekord och steg 0,4% respektive 0,9%. Vi fick kinesisk PMI nu under morgonen och den siffran backade för augusti. Asienbörserna handlades inledningsvis ner på det här men har nu vänt upp och stängde på plus. Nu är det äntligen dags att prata med Longview Economics igen. Vi kommer som vanligt att köra marknadsintervjuer och makrokommentarer på måndagar, men igår var det banking holiday i UK. Så vi kör idag istället, men framöver blir det alltså på måndagar. Good morning, Harry Colvin. Great to have you back at the morning show again. Did you have a good summer?
Yes, we have, thanks. Great summer.
A lot to talk about today. Let's start with equities. What is your market outlook for the fall?
Yeah, well, look, I mean, I think, you know, markets are squeezing higher currently. There's an uptrend underway and it's underpinned by lots of things, plenty of liquidity. And we had a very dovish message from Jackson Hole in that respect. He did nothing to change the sort of uptrend type price action that we've been seeing in markets. He was very dovish. There was no surprises, no acceleration in the pace or the removal of monetary accommodation, whether that's QE or interest rates. And we had the rates market pushing back a little bit on the timing of hikes. So a very dovish message from Powell, as is often the case with Powell. And I think that extra liquidity is clearly pushing markets higher. So we're in an environment of ample liquidity and we've also got a very strong economy as well. So I think markets continue to squeeze higher through into autumn and indeed beyond.
As you said, Powell was dovish on Friday. When do you think the tapering will begin?
Well, I think we'll get an announcement on tapering later this year. And I think perhaps it might begin either at the very end of this year or perhaps at the beginning of next year. But this was the key thing about Powell, is that many were expecting some sort of tapering timetable to be announced last week and we didn't get it. And so, you know, that I think is the guts of his dovish message. So the point is we're now repricing a more dovish Fed than we thought. And that I think will take at least a number of days, if not a number of weeks, for markets to fully digest.
Are there any specific sector you are more positive to? We have had pressure on tech stocks this spring. Is it comeback for tech or what do you think?
Yeah, look, I think we should see some rotation into some of the cyclical parts of the equity market, away from tech, towards perhaps some of the value parts of the US and global equity market. And the reason I say that is I think bond yields, while they've been moving a little bit lower in the last couple of weeks, I think over the course of the rest of this year, Q4, and indeed into next year, bond yields should be really starting to move higher. Currently they're base building and there are a lot of macro and liquidity and positioning type reasons to expect bond yields to keep moving higher. And that should drive rotation out of tech, out of growth and into cyclical and value parts of the equity market. I mean, the labor market's tightening, but lots of other reasons though to expect strong growth in the US. I mean, the first one is that inventory levels are very low and there's a restocking cycle that's likely to begin and that will drive a lot of stronger activity. Households are very structurally strong. There's a very strong ability for households to continue to drive consumption growth over and above average growth levels for several years. We've got high productivity growth, and that was illustrated nicely on Thursday with that very strong GDP, NIPA corporate sector profits data, fastest quarterly profits growth on record. Of course, there were some base effects, but it speaks to the strong productivity in the US economy in this recovery. We've also got more fiscal stimulus on the way. We've got a strong corporate sector, which is throwing off free cash flow. And we've got housing in the US that looks set to re-accelerate. That's typically what happens to housing activity when you get such large and sharp falls in bond yields. It stimulates housing activity. So I think there's a lot of production that's coming there. And we've got a strong banking system as well. Banks have got a lot of capital that they want to lend out into this recovery, put their cash to work. So at some stage, I think we'll start to see a credit impulse emerging as well. So I think it's a pretty strong growth outlook. And that's what's interesting about today. The consensus is pretty concerned. There's a lot of investors in markets are troubled about the recent slowdown in growth. And you can see that in the Merrill Lynch Fund Manager survey. You can see it in some of the sentiment in indicators that we look at as well. So I think that's where we'll start to see a bit of a repricing in markets generally, and it'll show up particularly in the bond market and in rates.
So a lot to be positive about. What is the risks here, Harry?
Yeah, good question. I mean, one of the risks is that the Delta variant spreads, or indeed generally coronavirus mutates and there's another strain. I mean, I think that's always a risk that's bubbling away in the background. There are certainly risks in China. China's economy is slowing. They're starting to stimulate, or at least there's some expectation that the authorities will stimulate in China. But at the same time, they're tightening up on a lot of policies, particularly on regulatory policies. So there are risks in China. And there are, of course, risks that, the US economy slows further than we thought. There's more of a slowdown than we thought. So as always, there are risks. I think the risk reward, though, is very attractive for equities and other risk assets at this point.
Thank you, Harry. Talk to you on Monday again.
Excellent. Thanks very much.
Och här på Pareto har vi pratat Surgical Science, Renewcell och Biovica. Vi börjar med Surgical Science där vi höjer riktkursen rejält till 320 från tidigare 160. Vi höjer våra estimat efter uppköpet av Symbionics. Vi förväntar oss att Surgical Science skulle fortsätta sin konsolideringsstrategi, men det här uppköpet var mer än vad vi hade väntat oss. Surgical Science kommer nu bli den ledande leverantören av robotsimulatorer och har potentialen att nå 100% av alla robotplattformar. Och jag intervjuade Surgical Science om det här förra veckan. Jag kan länka till intervjun här nedan. Och Gisli Hennemark, vd på Surgical Science, kommer även att presentera imorgon på Paretos årliga healthcare seminarium. Så vill man lyssna in på det så kommer han presentera imorgon klockan 14, så det är bara att kontakta sin mäklare här på Pareto om man är intresserad av det. Ett annat bolag som kommer imorgon och ett annat bolag vi pratar om nu i morse var Biovica. Där upprepar vi vår köprekommendation och vår riktkurs på 103 kronor aktien. Och den här aktien har varit under press dels på grund av covid, men också på grund av FDA-frågetecken och Arcosells problem. Men vi är fortsatt positiva till bolaget och vår analytiker Dan Axgutti har varit i kontakt med 5 olika experter som också är positiva till Biovica. Och samtidigt så finns det en hel del spännande event att se fram emot nu här under slutet av 2021 och 2022. Så det är ett bra köpläge i aktien nu, menar vår analytiker Dan. Biovica presenterar imorgon klockan 12 om man vill lyssna in på det. Slutligen så pratade vi Renewcell idag. Vi upprepar köp och riktkurs på 315 och vi tycker väl att de är på rätt spår. Mer om det nästa vecka. Tack så mycket, och som sagt, vill ni lyssna in på Pareto Securities Healthcare-konferens så är det bara att gå in på paretosec.se, läs mer. Ni kan anmäla er inne på webbplattformen eller kontakta er mäklare. Tack så mycket, ha nu en riktigt fin tisdag. Så ha en fin tisdag.